Loophole proudly presents. Viking Chronicles, presented by Loophold. Viking Chronicles is brought to you by...
Hey folks, we're living in the real world, we operate in the real world, so why don't we train in the real world? We're out here, we love to have fun, we love to hunt, but more than anything, I love to teach. So Rob and I want to take a few minutes of your time. We're going to go down here and show you a few tricks of the trade for shooting from high angles and how to build that position and what's going through our minds as we get ready to take that shot of a lifetime. So one of the things that Rob Wiley does for a living is he teaches people how to shoot, hunters how to shoot, and some special forces and federal law enforcement guys as well, how to shoot from high angles in this crazy terrain.
All right, so what we're doing here is as Rob is building his position, I'm getting the spot and scope ready to try to look over his head. So if he's really hanging 10, it's a good idea for me to put those together for him so he can deal with that. He's got his shooting sticks there. He's got a bag under his arm so he can get totally stable.
I'm good and solid here. I've got the sling in front of the sticks. I'm working on trying to make sure the sticks are perpendicular to the gun, so when the gun recoils, it'll lift off the sticks and then set back down.
So at this point, if we had a close shot, I could probably just do the spotting with the binos. But if we had a far shot, I would try to get this spotting scope set up and talk Rob into whatever animal it is. One of the things that we've got to also make sure is that we actually have our shooting sticks on our fore end and not on our barrel, because if we end up with those on our barrel, we're going to be off by feet at some of these ranges, normally shooting high. I don't care how stiff your barrel is, if you put your barrel on your shooting sticks, you're going to have an issue. If he's building up a good position, if you can use your sling a little bit, that's an advantage here. It's a little bit tricky. I like to bring my knee up so I can get my elbow on his knee. He has his kind of holding that bipod in place, but if he brings it up, now he can get elbow on knee. And Rob, why don't you talk a little bit about bone on bone and your natural point of aim?
My right hand, I've got my elbow down on the rock. I've got my other elbow on my left side, it's on top of my knee, and then that's a connection, you know, through my leg to the ground. So I've got this bone-to-bone connection to the ground, and that just helps you for a stable shot. You know, I kind of go through a checklist, natural point of aim, bone-to-bone connection, and muscle relaxation before I take a shot.
He talked about having his sling in front of his shooting sticks so that when he fires, the shooting sticks don't fall off the side of this cliff we're on. Okay, Rob, let's get ready to take the shot.
What do you military guys say? Eyes on the target?
I think it's gun up.
Gun up?
Scope up.
Scope up.
Send it.
Viking Chronicles with Kyle Lamb.